Hi, I'm Nina from Pessler, and today I'm going to show you how to add the WMI storage pool and the WMI disk health sensor. Before getting started with the actual sensor setup today, I want to go over a couple of points. So today we're going to be working with two WMI sensors, which means the credentials of the user you're using, of course, should have the right permissions. These should be either the user should be part of the same domain administrator group in the same Active Directory as your target computer, or if this is not the case, he should be at least part of the same local administrators group, DCOM group, and performance monitoring group as the target computer. If there are any questions surrounding these settings or any other WMI troubleshooting tips and tricks you'll need, there's a link that we'll post below this video that will actually give you exactly this. So now let's get started with PRTG. As you can see, I already have my PRTG up and running, and I'm going to quickly navigate to my device tree and look for the server I want, which is this one down here. And I'm just going to quickly add the sensor by clicking on this little plus and add sensor here. As usually, you can use the parameters up here to narrow down your search a bit. And I'm going to use WMI because those are the only ones I'm interested in today. And the first one I'm going to show you is the disk health sensor. Again, by clicking on the little plus, I'll be adding the sensor. And as you can see, the setup is pretty straightforward. You just choose one or all of the options you're giving. And now we actually just have to scroll down and look for our sensor, which is this one. And while the sensor starts to pull data, I can talk a little bit about the channels we'll see. As you can see, there is a health status and operational status channel. The health status will, of course, let you know if your disk is healthy, unhealthy, or, for example, in a warning or unknown state. And the operational status will tell you if it's okay or not. And thank God, my disk is fine. Now that we've done this, let's go back to my Hyper-V. And add the second sensor, which is the storage pool sensor. Of course, the storage pool sensor is better for bigger projects and will not give you as much detail, but you'll get a great overview over how things are going. So let's type storage pool. And I'll choose the WMI one. Again, the setup is very straightforward, not much options this time for me. Again, I'll have to scroll down. I'll use this one. And again, we'll just have to wait a couple of seconds till our sensor pulled the data. There it is. Again, thank God, mine is green. We can see I'll also get the free space available in gigabyte and the free space available in percentage.
If you find this video helpful, feel free to like it and consider watching our other videos on our channel. If you still have questions, please contact support@pessler.com. And always feel free to comment for feedback or suggestions for other topics. Thank you.